Check this out. Bernard Hopkins' son, today is his birthday. His name's Bernard Hopkins. He's the MVP of his football league.
Oh my God.
What was going through your mind when you were in the parade?
I don't know.
It was cool?
It was cool.
People waving and stuff like that, yeah.
What were you thinking, Shane?
This is great because the town, the whole town get behind the box like this. And this is what I love, so it's great for me.
And they love you, they were cheering for you, they were dancing, they were yelling your name in Spanish.
Yeah. Puerto Rican.
Do you know Sean Porter? He's a two-division champion.
We share some pleasantries.
He played football growing up too. He was really good. So you want to be in the NFL or you want to be a boxer?
NFL?
Boxer?
I'm mad at
you. He's a running back.
Running back?
He's quick.
He's running back too?
Okay, I've seen you on a basketball court, celebrity games, basketball pickup games, Pomona. Yesterday I asked Sean Porter, who's the best basketball player in boxing? And he told me it was Terrence Crawford.
He's all right now, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought that he probably is. I don't know, but I think Roy Jones was the best back in the day.
I didn't think about Roy.
Roy played, you know, he played basketball right before he fought. But that's here, in the boxers, that's here. I would say Roy Jones is probably the best basketball player, but I don't know.
Drake can ball too.
He good?
Play.
I tell everybody it's Sean Porter and Adrian Broner because I've seen them play.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I brought him once to play with Pacquiao. They never brought him back again.
Who does?
Hey, I brought you to play with Pacquiao. They did not bring you back a second time.
I'm just an athlete, that's all.
Shane could play.
I used to be a player. I popped off 5 keys. I ain't playing no more. I'm done. I retired from playing basketball. I'm done.
So, Shane, who would you want to do exhibition with?
I would do it with them.
What if it gets heated in the exhibition?
I'm down for that too.
Whatever.
I just retired when I was 46, so I still could do it.
That punch you landed on Floyd, everybody still talks about it to this day. How many people this weekend have approached you and asked you about it?
So many people. But the end result was Floyd won the fight, so.
That's
but it was a great fight. But he did what he did to win, and he was a champ.
When you look back at your career, what are some of your biggest memories?
The biggest memory is winning my first world title. And also, I think the fight with Oscar De La Hoya at the Temple, that was a big moment for me. So many people came, and it was just the biggest fight really in the world at that time. You know, so
he got a statue. Now we need to get Shane Mosley a statue in front of Staples Center.
I need a statue, but it's called the Crypto Center now. So,
that's true.
So they gave him Staples Center, so maybe I should get the Crypto.
I agree. Hey, you're in the Hall of Fame, and you can't go any bigger than this. Like, this is like from boxing.
This is the top. This is the last step right here. This is when I was his age. This is who I thought about being great. You know what I'm saying? I was like, you know, 10, 11 years old, I'm like, I'm going to be a great fighter. I'm going to be the best. And I fulfilled that dream. Now we're here, so I'm happy.
Shane, you're very friendly, but you've always been super friendly. How do you turn out in the ring when you have to knock people out, but you're their friends or you get along with them?
Because you have to separate. And I was talking to at a very young age. You have to separate your business from your other life. You have to be two people. So when I went to the ring, it was like I'm seeking, destroy, and kill. Outside the ring, I'm happy. I'm friendly with everybody. I want to be friends with everybody. But inside the ring, it's like whatever event you're doing, whatever sport you're doing, you gotta be like, you know what I'm saying? Look at me. You got to be like, I'm ready. I'm coming to win. Because they better be coming to win. If they're not, then I'm gonna win.
Okay, who's the biggest trash talker you ever fought? Who would not stay quiet the entire fight? Just was talking and talking. Did he say anything? Do you remember to this day?
I don't remember, but he was like, I'm up 2 rounds, but I'll hit you with the jab, or somebody would tell me, like, you know, oh, I got you. You know,
who had the fastest hands?
I don't know, man. There's some people had fast hands.
Was it Pacquiao? Was it?
Is that Oscar actually is in the running?
Wow.
Oscar De La Hoya was really fast when I fought him. Mayweather and Pacquiao is fast too. Pacquiao's fast for throwing a lot of punches. Whereas Mayweather's fast on the drop, like drop, you know, gets you. Oscar's fast on that foot. And that foot came like, I don't know, like a jab.
Who was the most heavy-handed?
You know, it's funny. I think Mayorga was the most heavy-handed.
Really?
Yeah, but Mayorga, because his hand, like, yeah, he throws punches or whatever. How he throws it.
Well, that was following my next one. Who was the dirtiest guy you ever fought? Mayorga. last thing, smartest guy you ever followed?
Mayweather was really smart and technical and what stuff. He knew how to get out the way, and he also had decent power too, but he was really smart.
If you could have a rematch with either Floyd or Manny in a fight, who would you want to rematch? Because you didn't rematch any of those two.
They're both equally. But I think, both.
All right, there you have Shane Mosley, now in the Hall of Fame. At Shane Mosley on Instagram, make sure to support him. What a nice people.